All right, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
If you'll please stand, and we're going to have a word of prayer this morning, again by one of our favorite pastors, John Baird. And before Pastor Baird prays too, again, please keep the family of Ed Humphrey in your prayers, and Ed, of course, as he continues to recover from that. With that, Pastor.
What happened to, I didn't know that.
He was in a very bad car accident.
2 weeks ago.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. All right, thank you. Thank you. You know, at this time, we're 8 days away from celebrating Christmas, God coming in human form, right? The Advent. And I know that different groups celebrate that in different ways. But a question that I always get asked, and I was thinking about it on the way here, because I actually got asked twice this morning already. And people say this to me, they say, hey, you know, I believe that Jesus came. I believe he did all the things he said he did. But since he came and he said it's finished, why are all these bad things still happening? Why do we see so much suffering, pain? And I think sometimes we forget that we're in the middle of the Advent still. You know, we're in the middle of Jesus's coming. And we have this privilege of living on this side of eternity in what's known as the age of grace. And we're different than anybody else in the Bible because we live by faith and not by sight. And our faith is on the fact that God will have mercy and grace on us, on fallen humankind. And so I think sometimes we just need to remember that, you know, that we have to keep fighting the battle and keep being encouraged. So just remember, first time Jesus came, he came to a crucifixion. When he comes back, he's coming to a coronation. And everything's going to be set right. So if we could all bow our heads. Father, we just thank you today for this time together. Lord, I just lift all the people in this room up to you, Lord, the desires of their hearts for their safety, for their decisions, Lord, that your will go forward in their lives, that your hedge of protection be around them, around this community, and around their families and the decisions they make. Father, we lift Ed Humphrey and his family up to you, Lord. And Lord, we just ask now for a complete healing, Lord. We ask for peace to be on his family, Lord, and for you to just infiltrate every aspect of his being with your healing power. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you all. Bless you all.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas, brother. And if you'll join me in the Pledge of Allegiance, and before we do the pledge too, if you'll keep in your thoughts and prayers again, our men and women in the military, especially those in harm's way, and their families, again, since they cannot be united with them this holiday season.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, David, first thing on our agenda is paying our bills, resolution number 181-15, and is there a motion to adopt that resolution?
I will make the motion to pay the bills in the amount of $3,656,686.63.
A second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Connie, good morning.
Good morning.
Connie, you're not getting better.
I am.
I say you were limping a little less last week.
No, don't tell me that. Slow but sure. Item number two is the recommendation of Judy Eshman, Director of the Department of Job and Family Services, with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybolt, County Administrator, to execute a purchase of service agreement by and between the County of Claremont, Ohio, and Belfair Jewish Children's Bureau in Shaker Heights, Ohio, for the provision of residential treatment, intensive residential treatment, transitional open treatment, independent living, Monarch Boarding Academy for Autism, and Stabilization Critical Care Unit Services for children referred by the Department of Job and Family Services and or Claremont County Juvenile Court at the rates identified therein in Attachment A, attached thereto, made a part thereof, effective January 1st, 2016 through December 31st, 2016, pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions specified therein and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of a purchase order. And this is a renewal contract that we currently have two placements, this facility.
Great, thank you. Is there a motion then to execute the reference purchase of service agreement with the contingency as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Three, please.
Recommendation of Judy Eshman, Director of the Department of Job and Family Services, with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybolt, County Administrator, to execute a purchase of service agreement by and between the County of Claremont, Ohio, and Agape for Youth Incorporated, located in Dayton, Ohio, for the provision of traditional and therapeutic foster care services for children referred by the Department of Job and Family Services and or Claremont County Juvenile Court at the rates identified in Attachment A, attached thereto and made a part thereof, effective the 1st of January 2016 through December 31st, 2016, pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions specified therein and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of a purchase order.
Is there a motion then to execute the purchase of service agreement between the county and Agape for Youth, Inc. with the contingency as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Shubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Four, please.
Recommendation of Judy Eshman with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to execute an amendment to the 4D contract by and between the Department of Job and Family Services, Child Support Enforcement Division, and Claremont County Juvenile Court, Batavia, Ohio, previously ratified by the Board of County Commissioners on March 18, 2015, for the provision of services on behalf of the Department of Job and Family Services, Child Support Enforcement Division, including conducting hearings relative to 4D matters on behalf of the Division of Child Support Enforcement, which represents, one, a decrease in the unit rate from $110.79 to $57.27 per unit or hearing, and two, a decrease in the total cost not to exceed from $375,671.79 to $194,728.77, with all other terms and conditions of the aforesaid 4D contract to remain in full force and effect.
Pretty significant decrease.
Yeah. Is it the change the allowable rate or?
What happened here is this amendment's necessary in order to comply with the Ohio Revised Code, in which states that any 4D contract for magistrate services in which the magistrate dedicates less than 100% of his time to 4D cases, you have to utilize what they call a 4D multiplier in the budget computation worksheet, which was not done. So what had, in order to make that happen, the magistrate had to do a time study, consecutive four-week time study, to come up with what percentage of time that he dedicates to 40 cases, which turned out to be 46%. So we incorporated that into the budget computation worksheet, and obviously it results in reduced contract amount.
Is there a motion then to execute an amendment to the reference 4D contract as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Youbel?
Yes.
Mr. Pratt?
Yay. Five, please.
Recommendation of Judy Eshman, Director of the Department of Job and Family Services, with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to execute a memorandum of understanding by and between the Claremont County Department of Job and Family Services, Child Support Enforcement Division, and Claremont County Juvenile Court, Batavia, Ohio, for the provision of reimbursement to Claremont County Juvenile Court for, one, Child Support Enforcement's portion of the cost for the software maintenance agreement with Courtview Justice Solutions Incorporated, ratified by the Board of County Commissioners on December 17, 2015, for the provision of countywide software maintenance services for the period of January 1, 2016 to December 31, 2016, and two, Child Support Enforcement's portion of the cost of said software maintenance agreement, which is itemized as Net DMS, JFS, and Crystal Reports upgrades only, an amount not to exceed $16,386, effective for the period of January 1, 2016 through December 31st, 2016, pursuant to and compliance with the terms and conditions specified therein and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of a purchase order therefore.
Okay, is there a motion then to execute the memorandum of understanding with the contingency as recommended?
I'll make a motion for item five.
I'll second that.
Mr. Youbel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Six, please. Hey, Pam. Thanks, Connie.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Pam Haberkost, Claremont County Emergency Management Agency. So item number six is a recommendation of Pam Haberkost, the director of the Claremont County Emergency Management Agency, with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to authorize Robert L. Proud, Vice President of the Board of County Commissioners, to execute a service contract by and between the Claremont County Board of Commissioners and the Greater Cincinnati Hazardous Materials Unit, Incorporated, located in Cincinnati, Ohio, for the provision of hazardous materials preparedness, response, containment, and mitigation for the County of Claremont in the amount of $25,163.78 for the period of January 1st, 2016 through December 31st of 2016. pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein, and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of a purchase order therefore.
Is there a motion then to execute the service contract with a contingency as recommended?
I'll make a motion for item six.
Second.
Mr. Uble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Thank you.
Yay. Thanks, Pam.
Pam, yeah, that's a contract we execute several years in a row, right?
This is annually, yeah.
Normal. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Lyle. Item seven, please.
Good morning. I'm Lyle Bloom, director with the Clamart County Water Resource Department. Item seven is a recommendation to authorize the release of maintenance bonds to provide surety for the installation of water main extensions to service the following subdivision, and to accept said water main extensions into the county waterworks system pursuant to the Water Resource Department rules and regulations. The subdivision is Billis Bend Subdivision Section 3 in Miami Township, and the second one is Billis Bend Subdivision Section 2B and also in Miami Township.
Is there a motion then to authorize the release of the reference maintenance bond and to accept the extension into the county waterworks system as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Eight, please.
Item number eight is a recommendation to award the bid for the maintenance and repair of auxiliary generators for the Clamart County Water Resource Department pursuant to the specifications to Cummins Bridgeway, LLC out of Westchester, Ohio, for the lowest and best bid received on October 22, 2015, for a total amount of $151,419, effective January 1, 2016 through December 31, 2018, pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein, and the award of bid therefore, and contingent upon the issuance of the purchase order. And this is for preventive maintenance on our 70 generators that we have. This would be the generators at our wastewater lift stations, our wastewater treatment plants, and our water treatment plants.
Don't you have some, I would say, roving ones?
We have three portable generators.
Yeah.
Not all of our facilities have emergency generators at them, so in the event that they're out of power and we need to keep up, they need the electric, we would move a portable generator.
So these are part of the contract?
The portable generators are not. These are all the stationary generators.
Okay.
Which we have seven.
So we do preventive on our own?
Correct. Like that?
Okay.
Yes.
Is there a motion then to make the award of bid to Cummins Bridgeway LLC with a contingency as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Nine, please.
Nine is a recommendation to award the bid for biosolids management services for the Clamart County Water Resource Department, pursuant to the specifications to Utter Construction Incorporated out of Bethel, Ohio, for the sole bid received on November 12, 2015 at the base bid unit prices as outlined, for a total estimated amount of $1,619,109.40, and to execute the contract relative thereto effective January 1, 2016 through December 31, 2020, with the option to renew for an additional 1 year period upon the same terms and conditions. Pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions, and the award of bid therefore, and also contingent upon the issuance and receipt of a purchase order. This is a 5-year agreement for hauling biosolids generated at our wastewater plants. It also includes the City of Milford's wastewater plant and alum residuals from our Bob McEwen water treatment plant. It's a 5-year agreement, so it's about a little over $320,000 per year on average.
Is there a motion then to make the award of bid to Utter Construction execute the contract as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lyle.
Hey, Lyle, quick question on that. Don't seem like we do the biosolid contract every year, but this is a 5-year? Is this a different contract?
In the past, they were two-year agreements with a 1-year extension, and we made this a little bit longer. We also have there's a separate portion of this that we bid out every couple years, and it's for the tipping fees. About 80% of our biosolids go to landfill, so we bid out the tipping fees, which are from someone like Rumpke, what they would charge us per wet ton to dump there. And then 20% is land applied on farm fields.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Lisa, item 10, please.
Good morning. Lisa Gatwood, Director of Clermont Transportation Connection. It's my recommendation, with the concurrence of Stephen Riebolt, County Administrator, to execute a memorandum of understanding by and between the Board of Claremont County Commissioners on behalf of Claremont Transportation Connection and Claremont Senior Services in Batavia, Ohio, for the coordination of operations, maintenance, training, procurement, and marketing to provide more efficient transportation services in Claremont County, effective 1/1/16 through 12/31/16, pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein.
You want to explain a little bit about that?
This is something that we do every year. We do coordinate with senior services throughout the year, finding the best transportation for people that need it and which agency is better suited for them. And then also, when there are opportunities that come up for any kind of training or other things like that, we also coordinate with their staff.
Is there a motion then to execute the memorandum of understanding between the commissioners and our CTC and Claremont Senior Services as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And again, thank you all for the cooperation on that back there. Thanks, Lisa. Item 11, Andy.
Andy Kupta, Director of Community and Economic Development. Item 11 is my recommendation to approve the following electronic subscription membership renewal request for the provision of online software programs and databases, and to authorize the county auditor to remit the payments accordingly. I'll highlight in the table the subscriptions to ESRI, the bulk of which is for 48 GIS desktop licenses used by a variety of county departments, and the actual server license. That's why that one is so high.
Is there a motion then to approve the electronic subscription membership renewal request as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 12, please.
On that business courier, is that you get two subscriptions or was that one? I get mine for 65, but maybe this is a commercial.
This may cover the one for the Board of County Commissioners.
Okay.
Sorry. I'll have to look into that and find
that's
out.
That's not a big deal. Just renewed mine yesterday. It was $65, so I guess you got the discounted price.
Yeah, we get print and digital. I don't know if that's more. I'll find out and get back to you on that.
All right, 12, please.
Item 12 is a recommendation to authorize the county auditor to issue a check in the amount of $5 million from the Planning and Development Fund to the Claremont County CIC, Inc., representing the county's contribution for the CIC's functions under Chapter 1724 of the Ohio Revised Code for calendar year 2016. Pursuant to and in compliance with Section 307.78 of the Ohio Revised Code and Section 14 of the agreement between the Claremont County and Claremont County CIC. As Ivy Point land sale proceeds have come back to the county over time, they've been held in the development fund for future economic development projects, and this authorization will allow some of those funds to be transferred back to the CIC for future economic development projects.
Is there a motion then to authorize the county auditor to issue a check from the Planning and Development Fund to the Claremont County CIC as recommended?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Schubel?
Yes.
Schuproud?
Yay. 13, please.
13 is my recommendation to adopt resolution number 182-15, resolving a consent to the dual representation of the Board of County Commissioners of Claremont County and the Board of Trustees of Williamsburg Township by the Claremont County Prosecutor and the Assistant Prosecutors in that office, in and as it relates to the ratification of the Enterprise Zone Agreement by and between the Board of Trustees, the Board of Commissioners, and Millicron LLC for the exemption of real property taxes. This resolution states that if there is a legal question or dispute on the Millicron Tax Exemption Agreement, which is the next item on the agenda, both the Township and the County would need to obtain outside legal counsel. Williamsburg Township trustees already approved a similar resolution.
Is there a motion then to adopt resolution number 182-15 as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 14, please.
14 is my recommendation to execute an enterprise zone agreement signed between the Board of Trustees of Williamsburg Township, the Board of Commissioners of Claremont County, and Millicron LLC, with its main offices located in Cincinnati, Ohio, for the granting of a 60% tax exemption for 10 years on real property improvements made as part of the project as identified in the referenced agreement. Set exemptions commencing no later than December 31st, 2019 and not extending beyond December 31st, 2029, pursuant to Section 5709.61 through 5709.69, inclusive of the Ohio Revised Code, and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein, and to direct the clerk of the board to forward the agreement to the Ohio Development Services Agency, the Ohio Department of Taxation, and the Claremont County Auditor. Milacron is committing to a $6 million total investment in the Afton facility, of which $2.4 million would be for the construction of a 28,000 square foot building addition. The remaining $3.6 million would be for existing building improvements to house additional employees and upgrade the facility to support increased production. Milacron is also committing to retain 646 full-time existing positions at the facility and hire 149 new permanent full-time equivalent positions within 3 years of completion of construction. The new positions will have a total additional payroll of about $7 million.
So Andy, this is the exact deal that we talked about 6 months ago that's putting it on paper.
Yes, it's finally gotten to this point, and this was a very competitive project. Milacron was taking a very hard look at relocating all its facilities to Indiana. They did get a very, very financially lucrative proposal from the state of Indiana to move all the production facilities in Ohio out there. So the state of Ohio, Jobs Ohio, came up with an incentive package, and this was our part of the whole deal.
Good. Well, we're glad Cincinnati Milacron's staying here.
Oh, absolutely. And we have things still settled with the Williamsburg Board of Education. All their questions answered and everything.
The questions are answered. They were at the Williamsburg Township Trustees meeting, and this is a first for Williamsburg Township. This first enterprise zone they've ever done. This mm-hmm. program has been around since '88, and so it's the first one also for the Williamsburg School District. So they just didn't know. They didn't understand the process. So I think they're comfortable now.
Good. This is the win-win.
Yes, it is.
So motion then to execute the enterprise zone agreement as recommended.
I'll make a motion for item 14.
I will second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. I agree with Commissioner Uebel. I'm glad that they're staying because they've been a long time
I would guess
partner here.
Oldest company in the county, certainly oldest manufacturer in the county.
Right.
It's important to UC as well, UC East. Yeah.
15, please.
15 is my recommendation to adopt resolution number 183-15, resolving to authorize Robert Proud, Vice President of the Board of County Commissioners, to execute the joint use agreement by and among the Board of Commissioners of Claremont County, Sporty's Academy, Inc. in Batavia, Ohio, and the University of Cincinnati, in and as it relates to the funding in the amount of $500,000 set forth in amended House Bill 497, item C26685, enacted by the 130th Ohio General Assembly for the construction of an extension of the runway at the Claremont County Airport located at 2001 Sporty's Drive, Ohio, known as the Claremont County Airport Improvements Project, and is more fully described in Exhibit A, effective for a period of 20 years from the date of project completion and upon approval of the reference agreement by the Ohio Department of Higher Education, to authorize the University of Cincinnati to submit a request for the release and encumbrance of the stated capital appropriations in the amount of $500,000, and to establish a drawdown schedule and reimbursement process for the purpose of programming, planning, designing, and or implementing the aforementioned capital improvements at the Claremont County Airport, with said improvements directly benefiting the UC Claremont College campus in providing flight training and other educational opportunities accordingly, pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions as set forth therein. This supersedes resolution number 154-14, ratified by the Board of County Commissioners on 10-27-14. After a very long year of working with UC Sporty's and the Ohio Board of Regents, we finally have a new agreement that makes everyone happy. So the money should be available for drawdown by March, and I would anticipate construction of the runway extension should happen sometime in 2016.
Can we find out what the commission check is to UC for this? $500,000?
$7,500.
Yes. That's their fee for processing all of this.
Administration.
Administration.
Yeah, and the reason why UC is that we had to have an entity to administer the dollars from the capital fund through the General Assembly.
It's a very mysterious process.
Yeah. Yes, it is, but thank goodness.
Nice job for all the effort. I know you. You did most of the work on that, so thank you.
It was a team effort. Senator Eager, I think, really helped push us over the line here in the past few months and get some final agreement. So
good.
Glad to be there.
Good. Is there a motion to adopt resolution number 183-15 as recommended?
So moved.
I will gladly second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Thanks, Andy. 16, Brandon.
Good morning.
Morning.
Number 16, recommendation of myself, Brandon Heppner, ISD Director, with concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to approve electronic subscription update renewals for domain names and entries and premiums DNS services SSL certificates at the not to exceed estimated rates at and the terms outlined below pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions as set forth in the electronic subscription renewals, all of which are on file with the ISD department, and to authorize the county auditor to remit payment relative thereto upon submittal of the invoices therefore. Basically, $2,400 or $2,450 for all of our domain services for the county.
Is there a motion then to approve the electronic subscription update renewals as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Pratt?
Yay. 17, please.
17, the recommendation of myself with concurrence of Steve H. Raybould, County Administrator, to approve electronic subscription renewals for the provision of software and hardware updates and support at the not-to-exceed estimated rates and the terms outlined below as set forth in the electronic subscription renewals, all of which are on file with ISD, and to authorize the county auditor to remit payment therefore. Just to highlight what these are services that we use to get answers for different questions that come up in the county, or things that we use to help monitor network activity and everything like that.
SolarWinds doesn't have to do with SolarWinds, it's just the name of the company.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now we're starting to get some turbines here. In the
okay, is there a motion then to approve the reference electronic subscription renewals as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 18, please.
Number 18, the recommendation of myself with the concurrence of Steve H. Raybould, County Administrator, to approve electronic hardware subscriptions for the provision of hardware maintenance updates for the HP care packs on servers at the estimated not to exceed annual rate of $2,000 for the period of 1/1/16 through 12/31/16 pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth in the electronic hardware subscriptions, all of which are on file with ISD, and to authorize the county administrator to remit payment upon submittal of the invoices therefore.
Is there a motion then to approve the reference electronic hardware subscriptions and to authorize the county auditor to remit the payments as recommended?
I'll make a motion for item 18.
I'll second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 19, please.
Number 19, recommendation of myself with concurrence of Steve H. Raybould, County Administrator, to approve participation in the new enterprise enrollment in concert with the Microsoft Enterprise Agreement Program through the state of Ohio to extend county enrollments of Microsoft Windows, CoreCals, Exchange Server, Enterprise, and MSD license with software assurance, and adding in the additional 200 CoreCal license with software assurance to the authorization or to authorize Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to execute the program signature form relative thereto, effective for the period 1/1/16 through 12/31/19 at an estimated annual cost of it, of an annual cost of $130,978.60 pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein and contingent upon the assurance and receipt of the required purchase order therefore. Basically,
thank you for the explanation. I don't know what the heck a CoreCal is, but
this is our licenses for the all the Microsoft products that we use. In the past we've been paying about $200,000 a year. This is going down to 130 at least for the next 3 years, as we found some licenses that we did not need to re-up. With that said, with that savings of $70,000 a year, come 3 years from now, we may actually have to pay a little bit more than what we were. It's like $250, $260. I'm not 100% sure what that price will be then, because they are moving from having their products on the computer to everything in the cloud, which is what they were trying to get us to do this year. But we decided we could go another 3 years without doing that and continue on, since we were getting Microsoft Office 2016. Which is their current and latest. To our understanding, that's going to be their last one that's going to be on your personal computers. The rest of it's going to be in the cloud.
So maybe a year from now, how long until we're at that point?
We will be at least 3 years.
3 years.
Yeah, we're still using 2010 in some of the in some of the departments. We're vendor dependent, therefore we can't change things until like CourtView changes or until there's a couple others that they have to change before we can upgrade. So once all that happens, then we can upgrade to 2016. So, you know, it may be 6 years before we have to go to the cloud. We'll have to find that out in 3 years.
So the net effect of it all, since we do buy licenses, maintenance for all these products, when we go to the cloud and maintenance is part of it, because they're actually keeping it, is it the price is going to go up, price is going to go down?
Prices will go up.
So you go to the cloud and it goes up.
If we were looking at going to the cloud this year, we were looking at, I believe, about $280,000 a year.
Doubles.
We're paying $200,000 a year now. Oh, I thought this is decreasing because we're getting rid of some licenses.
When it comes to all this, I'm in the cloud. Is there a motion then to approve participation in the new enterprise enrollment, execute the program signature form with a contingency as recommended?
I'll make the motion to item 19.
I'll second. And 20, please. Oh, sorry.
Mr. Ubel.
You told me to hurry.
Mr. Proud.
Yay.
Yes and yes.
Just moving right along.
I told you in the cloud. Okay, item 20, please.
Recommendation of myself with concurrence of Steve H. Raybolt, County Administrator, to adopt the revised table of organization for the ISD department as outlined below in Exhibit A, attached thereto and made part of effective 1-1-2016 to further authorize the update of the appropriate internet links and appendages accordingly. Without having to go all through that, basically, since 2003, our department has not changed as far as positions goes with how IT is ever evolving. This brings us up to having everybody working under the position description that they need to be working under.
This is exactly what we talked about last week, then.
Yes. Okay.
Is there a motion then to adopt the revised table of organization for our ISD department as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Ubel.
Yes.
Mr. Pratt.
Yay. Thanks, Brandon. 21, please.
Item 21 is a recommendation of Alice Frick, Chief Deputy Clerk for the Claremont County Common Police Clerk of Courts. My concurrence to authorize Mr. Pratt, Vice President, to execute a purchase agreement by between the County of Claremont and NeoPost USA, Inc., out of Milford, Connecticut, for the E-Certified Connector Annual Support Agreement at a rate of $1,320 for a period of 1-1-2016 through 12-31-2016.
Is there a motion then to authorize the execution of the purchase agreement as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Ubel?
Yes.
Mr. Pratt?
Yay. 22, please.
22, recommendation of Alice Frick, Chief Deputy Clerk, Common Pleas Court, Timothy Rudd, Clerk of Municipal Court, Judge Herman, Court of Common Pleas, and Judge Shriver, Claremont County Juvenile Court, with my concurrence to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute a software maintenance agreement by between the County of Claremont and Courtview Justice Systems, North Canton, Ohio, for the provision of software maintenance for services for the Clerk of Common Pleas, Clerk of Municipal Court, Common Pleas Adult Probation Department, and the Clerk of Common Pleas Division of Probate and Juvenile Courts, for a total amount not to exceed $232,679. Pursuant to compliance with terms and conditions and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of required purchase orders.
Is there a motion then to execute the reference software maintenance agreement with a contingency as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Ubel?
Yes.
You're proud?
Yay. With your all's indulgence too, I know we have some people here from Senior Services. I think this is in reference to item 41. And rather than make them sit through all of the rest of this, and can we skip to item 41, please? Got to throw a curve every once in a while.
Possibly. Item 41 is my recommendation to award a bid for provision of services and facilities to be provided to the senior citizens of Claremont County, as those persons as defined in the Old Americans Act of 1965. During calendar year 2016, in conjunction with a 1.3 mil tax levied upon real property of the County of Claremont, pursuant to specifications therefore to Claremont Senior Services, Batavia, Ohio, for their bid received on 11-12-15 for the full amount of the net proceeds of the 1.3 mil tax levy for senior citizens collected in 2016, and execute a contract relative thereto pursuant to and compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein. The award of bid, therefore, in a concert with the Memorandum of Understanding for the coordination of operations, maintenance, training, procurement, and marketing to provide more efficient transportation services to in Claremont County, heretofore ratified this date and contingent upon the receipt and issue of purchase orders.
Is there a motion then to make the award of bid for our provision of services for our senior citizens here in the county to Claremont Senior Services, Inc., with the contingency as recommended?
I'll gladly make the motion.
I will gladly second that.
Schuble?
Yes.
Proud?
Yay. Anything you all like to say?
Thank you for moving it up on the agenda. working together. I think we've worked together for many, many, many years.
Mm-hmm.
We need a certain senior, the respectable man that he deserves and fiscally responsible man.
1982. Since then.
Well, that. Look forward to jumping and getting going on the campaign, so getting all that together.
That's awesome. That's great.
And Judy, this was, I know quite often we'll refer to this as a renewal, which is kind of what it is, but it's not. We don't use the term as renewal, but it is the same amount as it was before.
It's the amount that is the net proceeds, whatever mm-hmm. that is, as it's collected, yes.
It's the same mill,
mm-hmm.
put it that way.
Right. It's we've modified the bid specifications and the contract documents and whatever this year. But this is also for a period of 5 years, which is the term of the levy, but it's renewable on an annual basis.
Mm-hmm. Which makes it a lot more efficient than what it used to be.
It used to be annually, then
annually,
we went to 3 years, whatever, and Mr. Eigel took a look at it and thought it made more sense to go with the term, but to still have annual reviews, because
mm-hmm.
they are compliance issues that have to be followed.
Again, thanks for the continued partnership and for what you all do for our senior friends here in the county. All right, thank you. Y'all can stay if you want. You see how quickly we're jumping up now.
See you later.
Merry Christmas. 23, please.
23 is a recommendation of Judge Shriver, Claremont County Juvenile Court. With my concurrence, to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute a grant application to be filed with the Ohio Department of Youth Services, Bureau of Subsidies and Grants, Columbus, Ohio, for fiscal year 2015 funding through the Juvenile Accountability Block Grant Program for the project entitled Security Cameras Detention in the amount of $10,000 with a local cash match, therefore, in the amount of $1,112 to be provided from the Juvenile Court Special Projects Fund for a total project budget of $11,112 for a period of 1/1/16 through 12/31/16 pursuant to compliance with the terms.
Is there a motion then to execute the reference grant application as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Schuble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 24, please.
24 is my recommendation to acknowledge the receipt of notification from Pat Margaret County Engineer for his determination to close Pond Run Road through traffic between 2855 and 2872 on Pond Run Road located in Pierce Township beginning Friday 12/11/15 through Wednesday 12/23/15. The replacement of the bridge number T-767-0.68.
Is there a motion then to make the acknowledgement of the receipt of notification from our county engineer about the closure of Pond Run Road as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Schuble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And 25, please.
Recommendation of Pat Monger, county engineer, with my concurrence, to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute change order number one to the contract for Smith Construction, Fayetteville, Ohio, previously ratified by the Board of County Commissioners on 5/13 of 2015 for project number JA-04-14 relative to the Cottle Road Bridge replacement. Project located in Jackson Township represents an increased amount of $9,294.13 for a total adjusted contract price to date of $261,573.53 for additions, deletions, and or modifications.
The motion then to execute change order number one to the reference contract is recommended.
So moved.
Second.
Schuble?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay.
So Bob, is that the same caudal as your...
No.
No.
The double L, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
26, please.
26, recommendation of Pat Marker, county engineer, with my concurrence to execute a contract for minor public improvements by between the Board of County Commissioners and National Gunite, Johnstown, Pennsylvania, for repairs on the Miami Trail Stormwater District Project. in Loveland, Ohio, located in Miami Township in accordance with the scope of services identified in Exhibit A, attached thereto and made a part thereof, in the amount not to exceed $41,440, with said services to be completed within 75 days of the contractor's receipt of your signed contract, and notice to proceed from the Clamart County Engineer pursuant to and compliance with terms and conditions and contingent upon issuance and receipt of purchase orders.
So motion then to execute the contract for minor public improvement projects with the contingency as recommended.
So moved.
Second.
Hubel.
Yes.
Mr. Proud.
Yay. 27, please.
27, recommendation of Pat Marmer, County Engineer, with my concurrence, to accept a contract by between the County of Claremont and Smith Construction, Blanchester, Ohio, for project number LS-01-13, relative to the 2013 landslide stabilizations project located in Goshen, Franklin, and Washington Townships, as complete as of 6/13/14, and to approve payment number 4 final, which represents the release and retainage of the principal amount of $15,476.24 plus all accrued interest.
Is there a motion then to accept the reference contract as complete, approve the payment number 4 as the final, release the retainage, and the accrued interest as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Hubel.
Yes.
Mr. Proud.
Yay. 28, please.
It's a recommendation of Vince Farris, Clamart County Prosecuting Attorney, with my concurrence, to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute a full-service maintenance agreement by and between the County of Claremont and Justice Data Solutions Incorporated for the software support for the COPS case management system as outlined therein, and for a total amount not to exceed $4,600 as effective through 1/1/15 through 12/31/15, pursuant to and compliance with terms and conditions.
So motion then to execute the full-service maintenance agreement as recommended.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 29, please.
29 is a recommendation of Sheriff Rodenberg to execute a memorandum of understanding by and between the Clamart County Sheriff and the Brown County Sheriff for the housing of Brown County inmates at the Clamart County Jail at the rate of $1,175 per day for a guarantee of 22 beds for Brown County inmates, with the rate per inmate over 22, maximum up to 40, shall be based on bed availability at a per diem rate of $5.65 per bed per inmate, effective upon the execution of this exact document by the Brown County Sheriff and through the authority of his respective Board of County Commissioners, pursuant to terms and conditions in compliance with sections 341.12 and 341.13 of the Higher Revised Code. This agreement is, of course, being put in place because of the situation in Brown County, where they have an issue with their jail. They're having to do major renovations there. The sheriff and Chief Willis have concluded that they have the ability to house at least up 22 and then up to 40 if we're requested to. And these dollar amounts will keep Clamart County net zero. They're going to cover all of the costs required for our COs, and Brown County's covering all the transportation costs, et cetera.
This is, again, a win-win, showing the cooperation between the two counties. And I know they've been sending a lot of their inmates to Butler County, and the cost of not just housing, but the transportation back and forth. And so this will be a cost savings actually to them.
I said, I think I was talking to the commissioner in Brown County, he was saying it was 3 to 4 hours to transport somebody over and back, check them in, so.
And I think it was like $60 a day, just the housing on that, then they throw the transportation on top of that.
That's what we paid.
And you know, and honestly too, on visitation, if you know, people want to visit, then it's a lot closer than having to drive up there.
Well, it drops the rate to like $53 a day, and if they go up to 40, it's down to $32 a day. So
we also, you know, want to thank the sheriff and everything for working with Brown County Sheriff on this as well. Is there a motion then to just approve the memorandum of understanding again between our county sheriff and the Brown County Sheriff as recommended?
I'll make a motion for item 29.
I'll second that.
Mr. Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 30, please.
Item 30, recommendation of Sheriff Rodenberg, with my concurrence, to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute a pre-award conditions and standard assurances form as a designated subgrantee in and as it relates to the Edward Byrne Memorial Justice Assistant Grant. Application for funding theretofore filed online by the County Sheriff Honor after 5/18 of 2015 with the Ohio Department of Public Safety, Office of Criminal Justice Services, Columbus, Ohio, relative to the JAG program entitlement narcotics unit for a period of 1/1/16 through 12/31/16, and as required thereby for the receipt of funding therefore, pursuant to and compliance with terms and conditions.
Is there a motion then to execute the pre-award conditions and standard assurance forms as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 31, please.
Everyone's recommendation of Tom Ireland, Assistant County Administrator, with my concurrence to amend Appendix 4.09 of the Claremont County Personnel Policy and Procedures Manual with respect to the Claremont County Classification Plan to add the position of Systems Analyst 3, Classification 69153, Pay Range D, effective January 1st, 2016, and further authorize the updated appropriate internet links and appendices.
Is there a motion then to amend Appendix 4.09 as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay.
So, Steve, this has to go back to Brandon's comment, or will be approved earlier for his. Okay.
32, please.
32 is recommendation to designate Commissioner Humphrey, Claremont County Commissioner, to represent Claremont County on the Ohio, Kentucky, Indiana Regional Council of Governments Board of Directors for calendar year 2016. And further resolved to authorize reimbursements of expenses in concert for attendance at annual, regular, special, and/or emergency meetings not to exceed $50 per meeting.
Is there a motion then to designate Commissioner Humphrey to the OKI board as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel? Mr. Proud?
Yay. 33, please.
33 is a recommendation to designate Commissioner Uebel to serve as the alternate for Commissioner Humphrey on the Ohio, Kentucky, Indiana Regional Council of Governments Executive Committee for calendar year 2016.
Is there a motion then to designate Commissioner Uebel as the alternate for the OKI board as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel? Yes. Mr. Proud?
Yay, the pay's great.
Lunch is even better.
34, please.
34 is the recommendation to designate Dennis Brown, Claremont County General Health District Board of Health member, Matt Ernst, Assistant Vice President, Bethel Branch Manager, Community Savings Bank, Financial Institution member, and Commissioner Proud, Vice President, Board of County Commissioners, will serve on the Septic System Rehabilitation Financing Committee for calendar year 2016, pursuant to compliance with Article 3, Sub A of the Claremont County Septic System Rehabilitation Financing Program.
Is there a motion then to make the appointments to the Septic System Rehabilitation Financing Committee as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Yvonne?
Good morning.
35, please.
It's my recommendation as the benefit coordinator for Claremont County with the concurrence of Stephen H. Rabel, County Administrator, to approve the renewal of the existing administrative services contract and addendum A by and between Claremont County of Ohio and Dental Care Plus Incorporated of Cincinnati, Ohio, for the provision of administrative functions and claim services for dental care benefits for all eligible employees and their dependents through the Dental Care Plus plan at the guaranteed administrative fee of $4.05 per participant per month, effective 1-1 of 2016 through 12-31 of 2016. Pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein and contingent upon the issuance of purchase order.
Is there a motion then to approve the renewal of the existing administrative services contract and also addendum A between the county and Dental Care Plus with a contingency as recommended?
I'll make a motion for item 35.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And 36, please.
My recommendation with the concurrence of Stephen H. Rabel, County Administrator, to authorize Robert L. Proud, Vice President of the Board of County Commissioners, to execute the multi-year contract policy VC-19 effective January 1st, 2011 by and between Board of County Commissioners and the IMED Vision Care business of Mason, Ohio, underwritten by Fidelity Life Insurance Company for the provision of vision care services for all eligible employees and their dependents in accordance with the amended rate schedule attached for the period of January 1st, 2016 through December 31st of 2016, pursuant to the terms and conditions set forth therein and contingent upon the issuance of purchase order.
Is there a motion then to execute the multi-year contract with the commissioners and IMED Vision Care with a contingency as recommended?
So moved.
Second the motion.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 37, please.
This is my recommendation of concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to execute the service agreement by and between the Board of County Commissioners of Claremont, Ohio, and Park National Bank of Southwest Ohio and Northern Kentucky for the provision of administrative services and to act as the depository of choice for the health savings account for Claremont County employees pursuant to and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth therein.
Is there a motion then to execute the reference service agreement between the commissioners and Park National Bank as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And Commissioner Uebel, I want to thank you because I know you had something to do with actually them putting in, you know, a bid for those services as well.
I think we brought the work back to the county from Hamilton County or wherever it was. I'm not sure.
Absolutely. So thank you for that. 38, please.
Is my recommendation with the concurrence of Stephen H. Raybould, County Administrator, to execute the contract by and between the Board of Commissioners, Claremont County, Ohio, and Sherrod Snyder and Associates of Mason, Ohio, for the provision of administrative services relative to Section 125 and the flexible spending accounts for all eligible employees and their dependents at an annual rate of $750 plus $100 per month for banking services and $550 per month per participant for administrative services, effective January 1st, 2016 through December 31st, 2016, pursuant to the terms and conditions set forth therein and contingent upon the issuance of a purchase order, therefore.
Is there a motion then to execute the reference contract between the county and Sherrod Snyder and Associates with a contingency as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for all the work on that. 39, please.
39 is a recommendation to authorize myself, County Administrator, to execute any and all documents for and on behalf of the Board of County Commissioners, including the extension of operating agreement by and between the Board of County Commissioners of Claremont County and Claremont to the Rescue Humane Society of Goshen, Ohio, for the administration of the statutory requirements of Section 955.01 through 955.26 inclusive of the Ohio Revised Code for the housing, feeding, caring for, destroying, and disposing of unlicensed and stray dogs within Claremont County, previously ratified by the Board of County Commissioners, effect 12, 17, and 14, and exercise the option for the first of two renewals for these operating agreement per Article 27 to extend the ending date from 12/31/15 to 12/31/2016, the amount of $351,000, which represents an increase of $21,000 with all other terms and conditions. The original agreement to remain in full force and effect and contingent upon the issuance and receipt of purchase orders.
Is there a motion then to authorize Steve Raybould as County Administrator to execute any and all documents, which is including extension of the operating agreement and exercise the option of the first of our one-year renewals as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay.
So how many years can they renew? Just two?
Two one-year renewals.
Two one-year renewals.
Item 40, please.
Item 4 is my recommendation to authorize Commissioner Proud to execute an extension of contract by and between the County of Claremont and First Transit of Cincinnati, Ohio, to exercise the second of three options to extend a management agreement for the provision of transit system management services for Claremont County, heretofore ratified by the Board of County Commissioners on 2-6 of 2012 and amended on 9-24-13, extended on 1-21-15 for the first optional one-year renewal thereof for the additional one-year period effective 1-20-16 through 1-19-2017. At the rate of $8,525.39 per month for a total not to exceed $102,304.68. This is pursuant to Article 4 entitled Commencement and Term, State of Management Agreement, and in compliance with the terms and conditions set forth and contingent upon required purchase orders.
It's a motion then to execute the extension of contract between the County and First Transit, Inc., and exercising the second of our three options to extend that agreement with a contingency as recommended.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Pratt?
Yay. We already have completed 41, so 42, please.
42 is my recommendation to approve the request of Sheriff Rodenberg to amend Resolution 171.15 relative to the adoption of the annual appropriations for the County of Claremont for fiscal year 2016 by Board of County Commissioners on 11/18 of 2015. as it relates to the establishment of the legal level of control for the 2016 annual appropriations pursuant to compliance with Ohio Administrative Code Section 117-5-02 to set the legal level of budgetary control for the Sheriff's Office General Fund departments at the organizational code number 431000, which encompasses organization codes etc. through 440000 through the Sheriff's General Fund Adult Detention Departments at the organizational code number of 432503, which encompasses org codes as listed theretofore, included the annual appropriation resolution. Essentially, what this is doing is it's reducing the number of individual organization codes that have to be tracked down to a smaller group. And as you'll see later in the financials, we end up with a situation of having to shuffle money between all these different fund types. And the sheriff wants to reduce those down. OMB is in agreement with that suggestion.
So this is something like the cost centers?
Yes, sir.
They'll still track everything and budget, send the budgets to you to the level of detail with the civil court services, IMB, all that. But then the auditor will roll those up to one budget here in control. So it should reduce the number of budget adjustments we have, especially at the end of the year.
Oh, good. Is there a motion then to amend resolution number 171-15 and to set the legal level of budgetary control for the Sheriff's Office with the reference funds as recommended?
I'll make the motion for item 42.
I'll second that.
Mr. Uebel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. 43, please.
43, requests from departments to join professional organizations and authorize payment of the annual dues in the amounts outlined below for membership pursuant to section 325.21 of the Ohio Revised Code and to authorize reimbursement of routine travel expenses associated therewith, excluding expenses for overnight accommodations, meals for more than one day, registration fees, tuition, and or transportation by common carrier pursuant to the policies and procedures of the Board of County Commissioners and in compliance with the annual appropriations for fiscal year 2016, and they are listed in the table below.
Is there a motion then to approve joining the professional organizations, authorizing payment of the dues, and any reimbursement of routine travel expenses that are associated with that as recommended?
I'll make motion for item 43.
I'll second that.
Schubel?
Yes.
Schubel?
Yay. And our financials, 44.
I'm on my own today. That's not true. I have Mary in the office.
That's right.
This is the final meeting, of course, of the year for doing financial transactions for 2015.
Any highlights you want to make?
Well, I was just going to highlight this one. The general fund, the sheriff's items all the way down through the sheriff's records and support, those are all transfers amongst all of those organization charts we were just mentioning. So they net out to zero.
Okay.
Zero dollar amount changes there. The reductions you see in the three dependency workshop development and juvenile accountability block grant are all timing on the grant receipts. And there's big ticket item in there, CTC capital improvement of $1,022,043. That's related to bus purchases, which will not occur until next year, so we have to reduce them out of this year's budget. Disabilities is a reduction in revenues to get that into the appropriation level. And fleet maintenance ends up also with revenue reductions, and we have an issue with collection of purchase orders for this year, which will roll into next year. Reimbursement. Okay. And the
MVNG fund as well.
MVNG fund, okay.
And all that money is encumbered then?
They released encumbrances.
Yeah, okay.
Yes. So the encumbrances that are required for current year obligation should still be on.
Good. Thank you.
The budget transfers are all relative to making sure we have the funds in the appropriate places to cover payrolls.
It's good. Good thing to know.
That's always, yeah, it's good at the end of the year. And then reimbursement of funds is the from Children's Services, Workforce Development, and Child Support Enforcement to the Public Assistance Fund.
David, any questions?
No, it looks fairly regular.
Yep. So a motion then to approve the supplemental appropriations, the budget transfers, and the reimbursement of funds as recommended.
I'll make a motion for item 44.
Second.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Travel requests. 45, please.
At the Claremont County Municipal Court, Judge Brock and Judge Miles, 3 days, Columbus, Ohio, Municipal Judge Association 2016 Winter Conference, estimated not to exceed $1,858. County Sheriff's Office, Paul McDonald and Travis Blanton, 1 day at Lexington, Ohio, for the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course, Mid-Ohio Advanced Emergency Vehicle Operations, expense of zero. And Sheriff Rodenberg, 3 days, Columbus, Ohio, for the Buckeye State Educational Foundation Sheriff's Only Conference, estimated not to exceed $757.
Is there a motion then to approve the training and travel requests with accordance to our county policy as recommended?
So moved.
Second.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Our personnel, 46, please.
Building Inspection Department, Stephen Rivera, Building Inspector 2, salary increase, merit pay increase effective 1-1-2016, my mistake. Department of Public Safety Services, Deborah Hamm, Emergency Resource Technician, termination, transfer within county effective 12-20-2015. And then Debbie Hamm, Emergency Resource Technician, and administrative leave, non-disciplinary with pay, effective 12-20-2015. Department of Job and Family Services, Brandon Addis, new hire, vacant position, effective 1-4-16. Ashley Blair, Social Services Worker 2, step increase, end of probation, effective 12-14. Tracy Gruber, Clerical Specialist, step increase, effective 12-7-2015. Reagan Kidd, Social Services Worker 2, step increase, end of probation, 12-14. Erica Willis, County Clerk 2, new hire to a vacant position, effective 1-4-2016. And Debbie Hamm, Income Maintenance Worker 3, transfer to a vacant position effective 12-21-2015. And in our Water Resources Department, Anthony Palmer, WSD Maintenance Supervisor, termination resignation effective 12-11-15. Ty Saunders, WSD Operator, probation and probation effective 12-29. John Weber, WRD Maintenance Technician, promotion effective 11-5-2015. And Joshua Klosser, WSD Maintenance Technician, termination resignation effective 12-15-2015.
Is there a motion then to approve the personal action forms as recommended?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second that.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And David, I know we have the minutes from our informal session for September 23rd. Is there a motion to approve those minutes?
I'll accept those minutes. Make that motion.
I'll second.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And I know there's been a request for an executive session, and that's pursuant to Section 121.22G1 of the Ohio Revised Code, and that's to consider the appointment, employment, dismissal, discipline, promotion, demotion, or compensation of one or more of the public employees. Is there a motion to go into executive session for that?
So moved.
Second.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. We'll be back in a little bit. All right, let the record show the Board of Commissioners came out of executive session and have resumed regular session, again with no decisions made in executive session. And David, I believe we do have the minutes from today's session in front of us, if you've had a chance to go through them.
Well, if that's the case, I will make a motion to accept the minutes from today's general session from December 17, 2015.
I will second that motion.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. Is there a motion to adjourn today's session?
So moved.
Second.
Hubel?
Yes.
Mr. Proud?
Yay. And again, as this is the last session scheduled for this year, I want to thank everyone for a great year. Successful year as always, and want to wish everybody viewing this too a very Merry Christmas and a very happy and safe New Year. Thank you. God bless.